Hello again, everyone, and welcome to another Magic Online video. I'm doing another Shadows of Innistrad draft, so I guess we'll see how it goes, and hopefully it goes pretty well. Right now there's six in the queue, so just two more, and the draft will start up, and we'll see what happens. All right, looks like it filled up. Okay, so let's see what we have in the first pack once it loads. Angel of Deliverance is the rare. A bit pricey for my liking. 8 mana, and you have to have Delirium for it to do anything. So not really the card I'm looking to take first pick. For me, the cards that I'm looking at here are Giss's Bidding, which is a solid black card, but I think this is certainly weaker than the white cards in this pack, which are Angelic Purge or Abyssinian Missionaries. And to be completely honest, I'm not actually sure which of these two cards is stronger. Both are quite good. And I think that Abyssinian Missionaries has a higher ceiling. And then Angelic Purge is just a more solid card all around. But this card just has such a high ceiling if you get to equip it. And equipment's usually what I want to be doing if I'm playing a white deck anyway, which makes me want to take this card. And it's also an uncommon and so forth. We might get more purges, but I'm actually going to take the purge because I think it's just a slightly stronger card. Although, maybe this sends a better signal too. That's also something to consider. Yeah, I'll take the missionaries, whatever. I changed my mind. I feel like this is a pick that I probably should have had to choose between in the past, but it was not. So, alright, so now I'm looking at a pack that has Aberrant Researcher is a good blue card in this pack. Tooth Collector is a good black card. And Rabid Bite's a good green card. Those are basically the three best cards I'm looking at. So I have to decide basically between those three cards which one I want to take. And I think that green is the best color to pair with white and just a very powerful color in general. So I'm leaning towards taking Rabid Bite. Also, there's like another solid black card here in Throttle which could create some problems. Maybe somebody likes the Diagraph Colossus. Anyway, I'm going to take the Rabid Bite. I think it's pretty close between these two. And this card's fine, but blue is just such a weak color that I'm not looking to jump into blue unless I can avoid it. So we'll take the Bite and see what comes out of that. Alright, so now we're looking at a pack that has a Lamholt Pacifist, which is a really strong card. And to me looks like easily the best card in this pack. So the Rabid Bite selection kind of got rewarded for that one. So I want to take this Lamholt Pacifist here. And other than that, like there's this Truth Faith Sensor, which would go really well with the Missionaries. And some other mediocre cards. A couple of decent black cards too, actually. But yeah, Lamholt Pacifist is definitely the pick. Alright, so then we're looking at this pack here, which is certainly not a very powerful pack, to say the least. There's really nothing good in here. I think I'm going to take Intrepid Provisioner, just because it goes pretty well with this Lamholt Pacifist that we already have. Pretty solid green card. So I think that that's the card I want to take. I could also take Inquisitor, which goes really well with Missionaries, but there's no really indicator that white is open, whereas seeing the Rabid Bite and the Pacifist definitely gives me an indicator that green's open. So I'm more inclined to take the green card here and go down that route. All right, so now we're looking at a pack here. And yeah, there's not a whole lot in this pack either. I could take like Stoic Builder just as a filler 3-drop. Wouldn't be the worst card to have. I could take one of these two blue cards, which are both fine. Like I'm thinking about taking this Just the Wind. Blue green's a solid archetype, and it's probably the best card in this pack. But blue green also doesn't enable Madness, which certainly makes Just the Wind worse. Stoic Builder is just such a replaceable card. Like, all these cards are so replaceable in their colors, so I'll just take a good off-color card and see what happens from that. Alright, so now we're looking at a pack that has a Stitched Mangler is a solid blue card. I think this card's pretty good, but we haven't seen much red. Got Steph Arsonist. Maybe red's just been really weak in the packs. Accomplice is solid. Black seems sort of open. But I'm going to take this card, I think is probably the best card, and kind of open ourselves up to a blue deck. Alright, so here I have a couple of blue instants that are medium level. I have an apparatus, which is fine if we want to do Delirium, but not that powerful, and this Thornhide Wolves, which I think Thornhide Wolves is actually a really strong card, so I'm pretty happy to take that. And this pack is quite weak. Well, I mean, it's actually not that bad for how deep we are. There's a couple of solid cards in here. I think I'm going to take the Fox, because there's no... Well, we haven't seen that much white, but I don't really see myself playing Homunculus or Catalog, and if we do end up white-green, we might want to play the Fox, so we'll take the Fox. Okay, so now we see our initial pack come back, and it still has a piece of equipment, an Inquisitor's Ox, and an Angel. So two white Delirium cards. We already have a couple of white four. We already have some fours if we end up in white, so I don't think we want this. And then it comes down to the Angel or Shard, which I think Shard's pretty solid for enabling Delirium and also good with Missionaries. So I'm tempted to take the Shard here if we do end up in white. And I don't think that Angel's really going to be that good for us, so we'll take Shard. And again, we have this exact same pick, and I'm just going to take the Fox again. And now, nothing too powerful here. I guess I can hate a... not too worried about that card. So we'll... I don't think I'd ever really want to play this card either. So I don't... Maybe I need a... Maybe I would want... Yeah, maybe I'd want a 3-5 at some point. So let's take it. Yeah, these cards are all bad. Let's take a random piece of equipment just in case. Take the Chasm. Take the Armory. All right, so now we're looking at probably a white-green deck, but could also be blue-green. Green seemed like the most open color. Well, we opened Thalia's Lieutenant. So this is going to make me certainly want to be into white, although we have a couple of foxes. We don't have that many humans. We're going to need some more humans, but I think Thalia's Lieutenant has a really high power level if we can make it work, so... that's going to entice me to go into that. Other options are the Quilled Wolf, which I think Lieutenant's just a better 2-drop than Quilled Wolf. Or I could take a blue card, but none of these blue cards are that powerful. I mean, the best cards here are looks like red and black, but yeah, I'm going to take this Thalia's Lieutenant because it has such a high upside, even if it doesn't end up being that great for us. Alright, so now... this pack has a strength of arms, but I want more creatures. I want to take as many humans as I can take, honestly, now that I have Thalia's Lieutenant. So this is a human, and then these are both humans, but I already have two human 4-drops, and I don't have any 3-drops. So I want to take the Parish Blade, which we also have a Shard of Broken Glass, which could help enable the Delirium on this, which is... it is pretty powerful if you get Delirium. So I think that that's going to be the card I pick here. And hopefully either Captain, Strength, or Cult comes back and we can get on with our Delirium lives. But or get on with our human lives. But I don't think that those cards will probably come back. Okay, so now we're looking at a pack here. Oh man, Ongoing Investigation. Oh no! Could have had a blue-green deck. But I don't think I made the wrong choice jumping into white. I mean, I guess it's not too late. But there's a Topplegeist, which goes really well with what we have. So I'm going to take the Topplegeist. Now. Okay, well, we're looking at another good green card, 2-drop here, Hinterland Logger. It's also a human, goes well with the Lieutenant, another Werewolf, etc. So yeah, I'm pretty happy to see this Logger, and Maybe this Provisioner will come back. Super unlikely, but you never know. Okay, well, this pack's great. There's a Byway Courier. It's a 3-drop human. Sign me up. Alright, so we'll take that bad boy. And now... oh, no! Tough pick here, because this is a human... a nice old human werewolf. Really powerful card, but Rabid Bite. And I think Rabid Bite's better, so... I'll take the Rabid Bite, but I'm not happy about passing Solitary Hunter. Alright, here I'm going to take... this pack is kind of weak. But Delirium's a thing that I actually kind of care about, since I have Topplegeist now and Parish Blade. So I'll take the Vessel of Ephemera, which can help me with Delirium. And hopefully I can get... maybe I should take the apparatus. Yeah, kind of. Man, I have a lot of. I have a lot of 2-drop things already. I have like 5 2-drops. I'm gonna actually just take the apparatus, which will also help me with Delirium. This and kill a creature. So made a decision to switch there. Ooh, look at this. This is a human, but this is a better human. So we'll take Stern Constable. That can also help with Delirium, etc. And another Stern Constable. I don't think I'm going to ever play... I don't think I would play 2 of that card. There's maybe a world where I do, but I'd rather just have the sideboard clip wings. Oh, the Inspiring Captain did come back! Hallelujah. Man, okay. So, we have a 3-drop human, which is probably what I'm taking here. I think Survive the Night... well, I don't have any instants, do I? Maybe I take Survive the Night. Yeah. This is a tough pick. I don't have that many 3-drops, but I really like this card a lot, especially in this style of a deck. So yeah, I took the Survive the Night. Oh man, the Provisioner did come back. Alright, so now we're just really all in on humans. As many humans as we can get. Now I regret not to... I regret taking this now that I got the second Provisioner. Yeah, it's definitely a mistake. I mean, it does help us with the Delirium for our 2 Delirium cards now that we have some sorceries and instant artifacts. So now, basically what I'm looking at for this next pack is I want an equipment. Wow, taking the land over the Liliana's Indignation. Okay, this pack is quite nice. So, there's a Briarbridge Patrol, which is basically just Hill Giant. It's certainly worse than any of these that I have already. And there's like a Puncturing Light, which is a pretty medium removal spell, not something I'm interested in. But there's also a Gossip Monger, which is one, a human, and another cheap creature to go with all these cheap creatures. So, yeah, Gossip Monger is just a Windmill Slam. It's certainly almost a perfect card to see. So... really happy to see a Town Gossip Monger in that pack. Now I am... yeah, just really want some 3-drops here. Maybe I can replace these foxes in the 2-drop slot. Some equipment would be nice. It's a lot of good cards. So True Faith Sensors... okay, well, Angelic Purge. Yeah, so True Faith Sensor and Angelic Purge are both really good cards for my deck. But Purge is just going to be better. It's going to enable Delirium, and it's just an amazing removal spell. And that's going to give our deck 2 Rabid Bites and a Purge, so we're going to have a lot of great removal. And this can help also enable Topplegeist, one more piece of removal. So I'm going to take the Purge, and maybe we get super lucky and the True Faith Sensor comes back. There are a lot of good cards in this pack. There's Unmaking, Moondrakes, Dance, Air, Inner Struggle, Tooth Collector, Duelist. There's... I mean, that's what, 7 really good cards right there. Someone, I mean, it's a long shot, but you never know. We'll take the Purge. Okay, so here's a 2-drop human, but it's pretty bad. Another Thornhide Wolves, but I don't really want a second Thornhide Wolves. So for me, the choice is I could take another Provisioner and just go crazy on the Intrepid Provisioners, which is probably better than either Inspiring Captain or Missionary, since we only have one piece of equipment. But there's a good chance this wheels, and I like this card a lot. So I'm going to actually take Confront the Unknown. I think it's a better pick, the best pick here for us. All right. Wow, this pack has all the goodies. So there's Vessel to enable Delirium, but I can't take Vessel over one of these good cards here. So we have Pious Evangel, just a good 3-drop human. We have, and Moorland Drifter's a 2-drop, but not any better than Fox, really. And then we have Thraben Inspector, just a nice, solid 1-drop human as well, to go with like our Gossip Mongers and all this stuff. So to me, the pick is between Inspector and Evangel. And I'm going to take Pious Evangel because we don't have, we only have 2 3-drops right now. So I want to, I want some more 3-drops, and Pious Evangel just has a really high upside. But maybe that's actually wrong because I have this Confront the Unknown. Maybe that makes Thraben Inspector better. All right, we're going to take Evangel, but I can't say for sure that's the right pick. Okay. Well, this pack is really good too. We have Militant Inquisitor, another good 3-drop that goes well with equipment in case we get a piece of equipment that would make our missionaries better. But there's also just Veteran Cathar here, which is a phenomenal human 2-drop. Double strike to all our we can give double strike to any of our humans. Just fits all the synergies perfectly. So that's exactly what I want. And then, wow, another Veteran Cathar. Yeah. Wow, and a Dauntless Cathar? Jeez, we are definitely in the right color, that's for sure. Man, Dauntless Cathar too. I think I have to take the Veteran Cathar, but I don't actually, man, is that even right? Dauntless Cathar might just be better. There's also Tenacity too, which is pretty good, but I think with this kind of deck, I already have Survive the Night and Confront. I don't need another sweet instant speed card, even though I like Tenacity a lot. Man, Veteran Cathar or Dauntless Cathar? This is actually a really tough pick. I'm going to go with Veteran Cathar, but I don't necessarily feel that that's right. Alright, so we have this Confront Provisioner pick again. Let's see if we get rid of some of these creatures that I don't really want to play, like the Fox. I just want to play like mono humans. I don't really want to play Thorn-Eyed Wolves. Yeah, I kind of just want to second Confront the Unknown. They just work better in multiples, and there's another Provisioner that's probably coming back, so take a second Confront. Awkward. Now we have 2 cards, Strength of Arms, which basically could have replaced Confront the Unknown, or Expose Evil, which I don't really want to play either of these cards. But I'll take the Strength, I think, is maybe a little bit better. Puncturing Light, we might play it. Oh, True Faith Sensor came back. Wow. And the Dance and the Blood Matter still in the pack. That's crazy. Provisioner came back. Yeah, we're definitely like 100% in the right spot. Oh man, the Militant Inquisitor came back too. Oh, everything's just coming up perfectly. If only we had seen those Dauntless Cathar and Veteran Cathar packs like much later, we would have just had the perfect deck. Alright, so I'm probably just going to easily lose the first round, so my deck just seems quite good. Okay, so let's cut this Unruly Mob. I'm probably going to cut this Inspiring Captain. I don't want too many 4s, and I think Provisioner is better. Because like our creatures are not that big, and like sometimes turning a 2-2 into a 3-3 just doesn't let it attack, but turning a 2-2 into a 4-4 is going to let it attack. So now we have to make some cuts here. So I want to cut this Puncturing Light. I don't think we want it. We already have a lot of removal, and I think I'm going to cut this Survive the Night as well, actually. And then I'm going to play 16 lands. Just going to play low curve, 16 lands. I think that's what I want to play. So this is 16 creatures and 8 spells, I guess. Yeah, 2 pieces of equipment. I think Shard's an underrated card, but yeah, I definitely want to play both equipment because I have 2 equipment guys. I want to play this for Delirium purposes. This could be the worst. This could get cut, but I think we can get instant and sorcery, and then artifact and a creature is definitely going to be easy. So another option here is I could cut Stern Constable and play another creature in its place. So for me, that would be like a Thornhide of Wolves or Unruly Mob or Inspiring Captain. But I don't want to play another 4-drop. I don't know if I really want to play this Stern Constable though. Yeah, if I had one more just nice human, that'd be great. I mean, I guess I can just play this. It's certainly serviceable. I don't want to play any less creatures. And I think Topplegeist is my only non-human creature for Thalia's Lieutenant. Yeah, I mean, this is also human too. I just think maybe, like, I could even see playing Strength of Arms over it. But 3 pump spells and 2 pieces of equipment, I think, is too much. And even though this isn't a human, I just really like this card. It's another option too, just a big beefer. Because, like, sometimes these creatures can get outclassed. But, yeah, I'm going to go with this. I'm just going to play 8 and 8. No matter what it suggests. Because I just want to have white and... I just want to have both my colors. So, I think 8 and 8 is just the right mix. But, yeah, anyway, I think this deck turned out really good. And we'll see how it plays out. But I think it's a really powerful deck. So, hopefully we end up winning with it. Make sure you stay tuned and watch the matches as well. We'll be right back.